To the outsider, this building is probably nothing special. An assembly of concrete and wood, nothing more. To me, there's no other place like it. You see, what outsiders don't know is that magic happens here. I've seen it with my own eyes.
This book is dedicated to you, my first child not yet born. You are 6.5 to 7 months along now, weigh about 1 to 1.5 pounds. You are fully formed and 14 inches long. I loved you the moment I knew you were conceived. I loved you when the doctors allowed me to listen to your heartbeat. And I loved you when I first felt the tiny ripples of your movements within my belly.
My mother once gave me a rather unique diary that she had kept in her early 20s. I say unique because all the entries in it were addressed to me, then her unborn child. In it, she tells the story of her ups and downs as an unwed, soon-to-be mother, and the story of my own beginnings. My story begins in 1985. It was right around then when my mother, then an unwed 22-year-old college student, returned from a trip to London, pregnant with me, her first child. This came as quite a disappointment to her family and friends, and she soon found herself with nowhere and no one to turn to but a group of committed men and women at a residential facility for pregnant women called Casa Teresa.
Casa Teresa is a residential facility providing a safe and secure place for women who are homeless and pregnant who have nowhere to go. We're here to do much more than just provide cheap housing. We're here to give moms a place to grow and learn so that when they leave, they can be successful.
Oftentimes, the typical mom who comes to Casa is a mom that has left their home in their early teens and have gone to live with a friend or perhaps another relative in another state, or they just do what we call sofa surfing. Many of them are moms who are then involved with unhealthy relationships where drugs are variable.
And imagine if that was the baby's story. Every child says, "Where was I born, Mom?" And if your story is you were born in jail, or I was in a motel, or I was by myself, I think that story is not the best way to start your life. Every woman who comes here has been thrown out of a family, thrown out of an apartment, has failed in some way. And maybe not from her own doing, but she's been thrown away. So we're very careful in everything we do to say, you won't be thrown out here.
Even though it was a lonely and difficult time for my mother, the efforts of the Casa Teresa staff to make her feel at home did prove to be very comforting and healing. Yet she also took comfort in knowing that she would not have to burden them for long. My mother had maintained contact with my biological father, who promised to visit and come alongside her in raising me. He would be arriving soon to take care of everything. But then days turned to weeks, and weeks into months, and my mother began to lose hope that he would ever come.
I wonder where he is. I wonder if he ever thinks of me and you. I wonder, how did it all ever happen?
The fathers of the baby are oftentimes instant gratification relationships. Oftentimes, these are guys that they have established relationships while they're out there in the streets or making bad decisions. And it's not that all the fathers are negative by any means, but a majority of them are not as healthy and not my first choice for the moms.
For the first time, my fate was called into question. My mom knew that I had to live, but was this 22-year-old college student with so much life and lived inside of her, equipped and prepared to raise a child on her own?
Sometimes I'm too scared to face the future, and you. I think that I should give you up for adoption, because I don't know if I can be a competent parent. I want what is best for you.
I think a lot of moms come to the CASA program with the child in them feeling some sense of insecurity, wound, sadness. So our job is to try to heal the wounded child that's inside them and to take their adult self and have the adult self rescue that wounded child and empower them to do that.
So everything we do is geared toward independence and success, not just getting through the pregnancy, but getting through successfully and ending up with skills and a way to care for themselves and the baby.
In 6 months or 8 months, it's hard to change someone's life, but I think that in that little bit of time, the girls really learn the basics, the foundation to be able to move on to something better, because they are struggling and they want to make that effort to do better.
We have 4 classes every single night. We have a counselor on staff, a clinical psychologist, and our nurse is a labor and delivery nurse who gives classes, teaches them about everything their body's going through. All the things that we put together are packaged in order that a mother and baby, when they leave together, will have a chance at a successful, independent life, not on government services, but for themselves to grow and mature.
Over the next several months, something happened. Something extraordinary. My mother's heart and spirit began to change. She not only regained much of the self-respect she had lost, but was now determined to raise me on her own. The future was no longer a dark and ambiguous destination, but now a hopeful one. And then, in the early hours of August 30th, 1986, the contractions began. And boy, did they come. According to the doctors, my spine was positioned right up against my mother's, and so the contractions were accompanied by hours and hours of excruciating back pain. And then, after 44 hours of intense labor and back pain, the future that had seemed so uncertain had finally come. I was born on September 1st, 1986, and given the name Shane. My grandmother not only showed up, but stayed by her daughter's side the entire 44 hours.
I couldn't believe how big, blue, and perfect you were. I couldn't believe that I had a boy, a son. They washed you off quickly and handed you into my arms, and you were wide-eyed and alert to my voice, as though you recognized an old friend you hadn't seen in years.
This past year, my mom watched with joy as her baby boy won Nevada State Championship medals for track and field, graduated high school with high honors, and began his first year at the California State University of Long Beach. Maybe this building is made of just concrete and wood, but there is something much bigger happening within its walls. After all, it was my first home, and it's where my mom turned her life around and found the hope and courage to raise me. Call it what you will, I call it magic. How do you even begin to thank the people who helped make your life actually possible? I once asked my mom what she would say to my biological father if they ever crossed paths again. She responded with just 2 words. Thank you. Maybe I'll start there.
Ah. remember your mom. I remember a few things about her. I remember one thing is, I remember that she loved life and that she was joyful. Because a lot of people came in here and, you know, life is really hard. And she was a joyful person. And I remember her looking pretty all the time. Yeah. And I remember her being very proud of me. She'd show off her baby really easily.
Meeting Shane was extremely exciting for me. When I heard that he was coming, I was thinking, like, one of my babies is coming back here. And when I saw him in the hallway, it was just like a lot of energy just went right through me. And I just wanted to hold him and kiss him on his cheek, which I did.
It was such a surprise to open the door and see such a tall, handsome young man with such a light in his eyes. And it just was a thrill beyond description.
His spirit seemed so pleasant and he seemed calm. And I'm thinking, like, hey, we were part of his life. So it was one of the thrills in working here.
When they come here, babies are born in a home. And I think it makes a world of difference. And when I looked at Shane, I thought, this is the difference that love makes. When there's a mother prepared and a safe place and a warm environment. We professionally let go of every mom when she comes. And as she leaves, we say goodbye. And we know that it's not our job to continue to hold on, but to let go and know that God and others will help her for the rest of her life. But not seeing that, it leaves a little void. So watching a young man walk in the door, it just gave us a great sense of, whoa, accomplishment. This is what we do. And it was like a gift. It was better than Christmas for me.
Dear Shane, I am giving this journal to you. It's our story. You might find it sad, you might find it surprising, but know this, I would do it all over again to have you. Always, Mom.